Okay, let's look at example 3. A well-insulated aluminium bar has 40 cm length and cross-sectional area 3 cm squared. One of the ends is maintained at a temperature of 130 degrees, while its other end is kept at a temperature of 10 degrees Celsius. If the bar is in steady state condition, find the temperature gradient along the bar, the temperature at a distance 10 cm, from the end that is maintained at 130 degrees, the rate of heat flow through the air. Okay, so we are given aluminium bar. So, lukis dahulu. Aluminium bar, which has a length of 40 cm. So, from here to here, is 40 cm. Okay, kita ubah kepada meter. 0.4 meter. And it has a cross-sectional area of 3 cm squared. One of the end is maintained at temperature 130 degree. So, kita letaklah dekat sini point A, dekat sini point B. So, dekat point A 130 degree. And the other end, which is point B, 10 degrees Celsius. If the bar is in a steady state condition. Okay, so this is the important keyword. So, when we're talking about steady state condition, meaning that there is no heat loss to the surrounding. So, dQ over dT will be constant. When dQ over dT constant, dT over dx will also be constant because no heat loss to the surrounding. Okay, first one, we need to find the temperature gradient. So, first question, temperature gradient, which is dT over dx. Di mana dT over dx adalah sama dengan final temperature minus initial temperature bahagi dengan the length or the thickness. So, di sini kita kena decide which one is final, which one is initial. Since we know that the heat is transferred from high temperature to low temperature, maksudnya daripada point A ke point B, so meaning that here will be the initial point, here will be the final point. So, final point is 10 degrees Celsius, initial is 130, divided by dx. X is the length, which is 0.4 meter. So, dT over dx is equal to negative 300 degrees Celsius per meter. Okay, next one, the temperature at a distance 10 centimeter from the end that is maintained at 130 degrees. So, we want to find the temperature at the distance of 10 centimeter daripada point A. Sebab dia cakap daripada the end that is maintained 130 degrees. Maksudnya daripada point A lah. So, daripada sini ke point ni. So, let's say this one is point C, which is 10 centimeter. We want to find what is the temperature here. Okay, so how do we find this temperature? Kita boleh gunakan formula either dQ over dT ataupun dT over dx. Depends kepada information yang kita ada. Okay, keluarkan dahulu formula dQ over dT, which is equal to negative Ka dT over dx. Since we want to find the temperature, value for T. Maksudnya, kita boleh dapatkan temperature tu daripada dT. Because we know that dT is final temperature minus initial temperature. So, dekat sini, kita boleh anggap point A adalah initial temperature, point C adalah final temperature. So, meaning that here we want to find TF. So, if we want to use this equation here, kita ada initial, which is this one, this one, X kita ada sebab dia adalah 10 cm. K pun kita ada, A pun kita ada. Tetapi kita tiada DQ. We don't have the value for DQ. So, the easiest way is we can only use this one here. Maksudnya, kita terus gunakan dt over dx sama dengan final temperature minus initial temperature divided by dx. Since the bar is in steady state condition. So, dt over dx is constant. So, kalau constant maksudnya dia akan sama along the bar, which is equal to negative 300. So, we can find the value for Tf. So, dekat sini negative 300 equal to Tf is what we want minus initial 130 divided by the length, which is daripada sini ke sini kan, 10 cm, 0.1 meter. So, the final temperature, which is the temperature at point C, will be equal to 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, last one. What is the rate of heat flow through the air? So, maksudnya we want to find dQ over dT. So, gunakan formula ni. So, soalan C, dQ over dT is equal to negative KA dT over dx. Dan semua information kita sudah dibagi. dT over dx pun kita sudah kira dekat sini. So, you just masukkan di mana negative still sama. K is 240. Area, this one, we are given in centimeter square. So, this one you need to convert to meter square. So, when we convert, we know that centimeter is exponent negative 2, right? But since we have square, so kita kena squarekan lagi. So, kita akan dapat 3 exponent negative 4 meter square. So, kena hati-hati apabila kita convert unit yang melibatkan square. So, here 3 exponent negative 4. And then dt over dx is negative 300. So, dq over dt is equal to 21.6 watt.